Welcome to Relaxing Boutique Channel. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Pearl of the Aztecs. Chapter 1. The Legend Awakens. In the lush, vibrant heartlands of the Aztec Empire, where ancient temples stood as silent witnesses to a civilization both fierce and wise, a legend long forgotten began to stir. Whispers of a magical pearl said to contain the very soul of Quetzalcoatl, the revered feathered serpent god, started to spread like wildfire, igniting a fervor among the tribes of the empire. The pearl, known as Chanticoe's Tear, was a gem of unparalleled beauty, radiating an otherworldly glow. Legends spoke of its creation by the god Quetzalcoatl himself, a divine embodiment of wisdom and harmony. It was said that whoever possessed Chantico's tear would be granted insights beyond mortal comprehension, but at a great cost, for the pearl also held the power to unleash chaos and discord if misused. As the legend reawakened, rival tribes within the empire began to vie for the pearl. The once peaceful coexistence threatened to unravel, as chieftains and warriors were drawn into the race to find this powerful artifact. The imminent conflict loomed over the empire, a dark cloud threatening to burst into a storm of war and destruction. In the midst of this brewing turmoil, a group of unlikely heroes emerged. Xochitl, a young warrior of remarkable skill and valor, was disturbed by the growing tension among the tribes. Accompanied by Takli, an elderly shaman renowned for his wisdom and knowledge of ancient lore, and Sivlali, a shrewd and resourceful merchant known for her intricate knowledge of the empire's politics, they embarked on a daring quest to find Chantico's tear and prevent the impending war. Their journey began in the grand capital of Tenochtitlan, where the hustle and bustle of daily life belied the underlying tension. The trio navigated through crowded marketplaces, majestic plazas, and along the banks of the grand canals, gathering information about the pearl's last known whereabouts. Their search led them to ancient codices and forgotten tales told by elders, slowly piecing together the pearl's mysterious history. They learned of its last known keeper, a high priest who, centuries ago, had vanished without a trace, taking the pearl's location with him. The only clue to its whereabouts was a cryptic prophecy, foretelling that Chantico's tear would be found where the serpent's gaze meets the sun's embrace. Determined to decipher this riddle, Xochitl, Takli, and Sivlali ventured deep into the dense jungles surrounding the capital. They faced numerous perils, venomous creatures, treacherous terrain, and rival tribe scouts who were also in search of the pearl. As they journeyed further, they encountered remnants of ancient Aztec ruins, overgrown by the relentless grip of the jungle. In one such ruin, a temple dedicated to Quetzalcoatl, they discovered a series of murals depicting the god's creation of Chantico's tear. The murals revealed that the pearl was last seen in the Temple of the Sun, a sacred site far to the east, where it was believed that Quetzalcoatl's spirit would one day return. The trio set out for the Temple of the Sun, their journey taking them through diverse landscapes from steamy rainforests to arid valleys. Along the way, they forged alliances with various tribes, sharing their vision of maintaining harmony within the empire. Sochil's bravery, Totli's wisdom, and Sitlali's diplomacy helped them navigate these complex relationships. As they neared the Temple of the Sun, the trio realized they were not alone in their quest. Scouts from rival tribes, mercenaries, and even rogue elements within the Empire's own ranks were converging on the temple, all drawn by the allure of the pearl. In a race against time and adversaries, Sochil, Totli, and Sitlali arrived at the temple as the sun began to set, casting long shadows across the ancient stones. The temple, a marvel of architectural prowess, stood atop a hill, its walls adorned with intricate carvings depicting celestial events and the gods' exploits. The trio carefully navigated the temple's corridors and chambers, deciphering traps and puzzles left by its ancient architects. Their resolve and unity were tested as they encountered obstacles that challenged each of their strengths. Finally, in the heart of the temple, they found themselves in a grand chamber where the walls converged towards a singular point on the floor. Here, a beam of the setting sun shone through a small opening in the ceiling, illuminating the spot where the serpent's gaze, a large, carved stone serpent's head, met the sun's embrace. As the last rays of the sun touched this point, a hidden compartment in the floor opened, revealing Chantico's tear. The pearl, radiant and mesmerizing, seemed to pulse with an inner light. However, their moment of triumph was short-lived. They were soon discovered by rival factions, leading to a tense standoff in the heart of the temple. Sochil, Totli, and Sitlali, with the pearl in their possession, now faced the daunting task of escaping the temple and finding a way to use the pearl to restore harmony among the tribes. Chapter 2. The Rival Tribes. In the heart of the Aztec Empire, as word of the discovery of Chantico's tear spread, the once stable alliance between the tribes began to unravel. Tensions that had simmered beneath the surface for generations now threatened to erupt into open conflict. The pearl's discovery was a spark in a tinderbox of rivalry and ambition. Sochil, Totli, and Sitlali, now the reluctant guardians of Chantico's tear, found themselves in a precarious position. They needed to navigate the intricate web of tribal politics and alliances, as various factions sought to claim the pearl for their own purposes. The first challenge came from the Tlaxcalans, a powerful and warlike tribe who believed that possessing the pearl would grant them supremacy over the empire. Their fierce warriors, led by the ambitious and ruthless chieftain Tlaxcalan, launched raids against neighboring tribes, trying to force the surrender of the pearl. To counter this threat, Sochil, a warrior of unmatched prowess, led the defense efforts. She rallied the warriors of her tribe, using her knowledge of military tactics and her skills in combat to repel the Tlaxcalan assaults. Her bravery on the battlefield earned her the respect and loyalty of many, unifying the tribes in defense of their land. Meanwhile, Totli, the wise shaman, saw a more diplomatic solution. He traveled to the Tlaxcalan capital, offering to share the wisdom of the pearl in exchange for peace. In the Grand Council of the Tlaxcalans, he spoke of the pearl's true purpose, not as a weapon of war, but as a symbol of harmony and balance. His words, however, fell on deaf ears, as Tlacala was determined to seize the pearl by any means necessary. Sivlali, the cunning merchant, used her network of trade contacts to gather intelligence and forge alliances. She uncovered a plot by another tribe, the Zapotecs, who sought to steal the pearl under the guise of a trade negotiation. With this knowledge, she orchestrated a counterplot, setting a trap that exposed the Zapotecs' treachery and weakened their position. As the heroes grappled with these external threats, they also faced challenges from within. The pearl's presence began to affect them in mysterious ways. Xochitl found her dreams haunted by visions of Quetzalcoatl, who warned of a great imbalance that the pearl could either mend or exacerbate. Tokli, sensitive to the spiritual energies, felt a growing restlessness in the land, as if nature itself was responding to the pearl's reawakening. And Sivlali, who had always valued wealth and power, began to question her own ambitions, feeling the weight of responsibility that came with the pearl. The situation escalated when a grand assembly of the tribes was called at the sacred site of Teotihuacan. Here, under the shadow of the Pyramid of the Sun, leaders from across the empire gathered to discuss the fate of the pearl. Xochitl, Tokli, and Sivlali, bearing Chandico's tear, arrived at the assembly, hoping to broker a peace and find a way to use the pearl for the benefit of all. The assembly was a tumultuous affair, with each tribe presenting their claim to the pearl. Tlacolo, with his formidable presence, argued for the pearl's use as a symbol of strength and dominion. Other leaders spoke of using its power to bring prosperity to their lands, or the need to hide it away, fearing its potential for destruction. Amidst this discord, Xochitl took a stand. She spoke passionately of her experiences on the battlefield, of the senseless bloodshed that the quest for the pearl had already caused. She implored the assembly to consider the cost of their ambitions, to remember the values of unity and cooperation that had once defined their people. Tokli, in turn, shared his visions and the spiritual turmoil he had sensed. He warned that the pearl was not merely an object of power, but a sacred trust, a test of their ability to rise above their baser instincts and live in harmony with the cosmos. Sivlali, using her persuasive skills, proposed a solution, a council of tribes, where representatives from each faction would share guardianship of the pearl, using its wisdom to benefit all, rather than allowing it to become a source of division. The proposal was met with skepticism, but as the debate continued, a surprising event shifted the course of the assembly. A group of commoners, farmers, and artisans, who had silently witnessed the proceedings, stepped forward. They spoke of the hardships and fear that the conflict over the pearl had brought to their lives. Their words, simple yet powerful, reminded the assembly of the responsibility they held towards their people. The chapter closes with the assembly in a state of reflection, the voices of the common people echoing in their minds. Xochitl, Tokli, and Sivlali, standing united, awaited the decision of the tribes, hoping that their efforts to prevent a war and restore harmony would not be in vain. Chapter 3. The Quest for Harmony. Following the tense assembly at Teotihuacan, Xochitl, Tokli, and Sivlali set out on a renewed quest, to use the Pearl of Quetzalcoatl to foster harmony among the rival Aztec tribes. The assembly had ended with no clear resolution, but the plea of the common people had sparked a glimmer of hope, a possibility for peace. Their journey took them across the vast and diverse landscapes of the Aztec Empire. They traveled from the bustling streets of Tenochtitlan, through dense, steamy rainforests, and across arid plains, visiting each tribe that had laid claim to the pearl. In each place, they sought to understand the unique perspectives and needs of the tribes, to find a common ground that could form the basis of a lasting peace. Xochitl, who had seen the horrors of war firsthand, spoke passionately about the need for unity against common threats and the futility of internal strife. She used her status as a respected warrior to open dialogues with the tribal chieftains, challenging them to see beyond their immediate ambitions. Tocli, with his deep spiritual insight, communicated the sacred significance of the pearl. He conducted ancient rituals that revealed the pearl's ability to evoke empathy and understanding, allowing tribal leaders to experience the world through their rivals' perspectives. These rituals, though initially met with skepticism, gradually began to break down barriers, softening hardened hearts. Citlali used her skills as a negotiator and merchant to propose practical solutions. She suggested a series of trade agreements and alliances, which would be more beneficial than continued conflict. She showed how cooperation and sharing the wisdom of the pearl could lead to prosperity for all tribes. As they journeyed, the trio encountered various challenges that tested their resolve and the strength of their mission. They faced skepticism and hostility, not only from tribal leaders but also from their own people, who questioned their motives and the feasibility of their quest. One significant challenge arose when they encountered a group of zealots dedicated to the god Huitzilopochtli, who believed that war was a sacred duty and the only path to honor and glory. The zealots saw the pearl as a divine endorsement of their cause and sought to seize it to legitimize their call to arms. In a tense confrontation, Xochitl's martial skills, Tocli's spiritual wisdom, and Citlali's diplomatic acumen were put to the test. Xochitl engaged the zealots in a display of combat prowess, demonstrating that true strength lay in restraint and the protection of one's people. Tocli performed a powerful ritual that invoked the presence of Quetzalcoatl, showcasing the pearl's true purpose as a symbol of peace and wisdom. Citlali, meanwhile, negotiated a truce, promising the zealots a voice in the new council that would govern the use of the pearl. The most poignant moment of their journey came when they visited a village ravaged by the tribal conflicts. Here, among the people most affected by the strife, the trio saw the true cost of the power struggle. Moved by the plight of the villagers, they organized a gathering where voices from all sides, warriors, chieftains, commoners, shared their stories and their grief. The pearl, placed at the center of the gathering, seemed to glow brighter with each tale of loss and hope, its light a silent testament to the shared humanity of all present. This gathering became a turning point in their quest. The stories shared here resonated far and wide, carried by the participants to the corners of the empire. The realization that the conflict had brought only suffering and no real victors began to take root in the hearts of the people and their leaders. As their journey neared its end, Xochitl, Tocli, and Citlali returned to Tenochtitlan to convene a final assembly. This time, the tone was markedly different. The presence of commoners was more pronounced, their voices joining those of the leaders in seeking a resolution. In this assembly, the trio presented the outcomes of their journey, the agreements forged, the insights gained from the rituals, and the poignant stories from the ravaged village. They proposed the formation of a council, representing all tribes, which would safeguard the pearl and use its wisdom for the collective good of the empire. The proposal was met with a long, contemplative silence. Then, one by one, the chieftains began to voice their agreement, swayed by the groundswell of support from their people and the compelling evidence presented by Sochil, Tokli, and Sivlali. The chapter concludes with the historic formation of the Council of Harmony, a body comprising representatives from each tribe, entrusted with the guardianship of the Pearl of Quetzalcoatl. The council would convene regularly at Teotihuacan, ensuring that the decisions made about the Pearl would benefit all and maintain the balance and unity of the empire. Chapter 4. The Pearl's Destiny. The formation of the Council of Harmony marked a new era for the Aztec Empire. The once imminent threat of war had given way to a cautious optimism, fostered by the tireless efforts of Sochil, Tokli, and Sivlali. Yet, the true test of this newfound unity was yet to come. As the council convened for its first session at Teotihuacan, the air was tense with anticipation. Representatives from each tribe, some still wary of their former rivals, gathered around the Pearl of Quetzalcoatl, which lay at the center of the council chamber, its iridescent glow a constant reminder of its significance and power. The session began with Sochil addressing the council. She recounted her journey, the battles she had fought, not just against external enemies, but also against her own doubts and fears. She emphasized the need for vigilance against the resurgence of old rivalries and the importance of working together for the greater good of the empire. Tokli, the wise shaman, spoke next. He shared his spiritual insights, describing his visions of a harmonious empire where people lived in balance with nature and the gods. He proposed that the council seek guidance from the Pearl, not as a tool for divination, but as a symbol of the wisdom and harmony embodied by Quetzalcoatl. Sivlali, with her pragmatic approach, outlined a series of initiatives for the council. These included trade agreements, joint defense strategies, and cultural exchanges aimed at fostering a deeper understanding and appreciation among the tribes. She stressed the importance of mutual prosperity and security as foundations for lasting peace. As the council deliberated, it became clear that the path to harmony would be fraught with challenges. Each tribe had its own interests and priorities, and old grudges were not easily forgotten. The council sessions were marked by heated debates and occasional stalemates. During one such session, a crisis arose that threatened to undo all the progress made. A border dispute between two tribes escalated into a skirmish, reigniting fears of a wider conflict. The council was thrown into disarray, with members divided on how to respond. Seizing the moment, Sochil, Tokli, and Sivlali intervened to mediate the crisis. With the Pearl as their guide, they embarked on a diplomatic mission to the affected regions, meeting with local leaders and the people impacted by the dispute. Sochil, drawing on her experience as a warrior, negotiated a ceasefire, appealing to the leader's sense of duty to their people and the empire. Tokli conducted healing rituals that helped alleviate the pain and anger of those affected by the skirmish. Sivlali, using her skills as a negotiator, brokered a compromise that addressed the root causes of the dispute. Their efforts were successful, and the crisis was averted. The resolution of the border dispute became a turning point for the council, demonstrating that even the most deep-seated conflicts could be resolved through dialogue and mutual understanding. Encouraged by this success, the council began to take more proactive measures to prevent future conflicts. They established a network of envoys and mediators, trained in the principles of diplomacy and conflict resolution. The Pearl, under the custodianship of the council, was taken on a tour of the empire, its presence serving as a reminder of the empire's commitment to unity and harmony. As the years passed, the council's influence grew, and the empire experienced a period of unprecedented peace and prosperity. Trade flourished, cultural exchanges enriched the society, and the people enjoyed a sense of security and well-being that had once seemed unattainable. The story of Xochitl, Tokli, and Sivlali became a legend, told and retold as an example of courage, wisdom, and the power of cooperation. The Pearl of Quetzalcoatl, once a source of division, had become a symbol of the empire's strength and unity. The chapter concludes with an elderly Xochitl, Tokli, and Sivlali standing together at the top of the Pyramid of the Sun, looking out over the thriving empire. They reflected on their journey, from the brink of war to a harmonious society, and the role they had played in shaping this new era. Their story was a testament to the idea that even in a world rife with conflict and ambition, peace could be achieved through empathy, understanding, and a shared commitment to the greater good. The Pearl of Quetzalcoatl, once the object of their quest, had found its true destiny, not as a relic of power, but as a beacon of hope and harmony for the entire Aztec world.